Say, what's not to love about the Let's Go Brandon phenomenon? In case anyone is unaware of the origin of Let's Go Brandon, its genesis is traced back to a NASCAR event last month. Chants of F Joe Biden were reverberating from the stands of the Talladega Super Speedway as reporter Kelly Stavast interviewed driver Brandon Brown. Stavast then somehow incorrectly described F Joe Biden as Let's Go Brandon. Now, how could this trained broadcast professional make such a mistake?
As you can hear the chants from the crowd.
Let's go, Brandon!
Let's go, Brandon. Brandon, you told me you were going to kind of hang
for starters, nobody, as in nobody in the stands, was chanting, Let's go, Brandon. And nobody was hearing, Let's go, Brandon, either. Rather, the Talladega attendees were letting Joe Biden know what they think of him in quite a profane fashion. Oh, God bless the First Amendment. The other reason I love Let's Go Brandon is that it illustrates yet again how the fake news media spins things in a way to protect Sleepy Joe. I mean, how in the world does F. Joe Biden become Let's Go Brandon? Everyone in the world knows what the fans were chanting that day, but those lying liars in the mainstream media could not report it. Shameful. In that regard, it reminds me of how Prime Minister Pierre Trudeau dropped an F-bomb in the House of Commons back in 1971.
He mouthed two words, the first word of which started with F and the second word of which started with O. And he said it twice to John Lundgren, the member from Gander Twilligut, and he also said the same thing to me.
Which was an especially outrageous thing to do for a PM, especially in that era. Yet, when asked about it, Papa Trudeau claimed he said fuddle-duddle.
Well, it's a lie, because I didn't say anything.
Did you, well, mouth,
sir, did you mouth it?
What does mouth mean?
Move your lips.
Yes, I move my lips.
In the words you've been quoted as saying?
No.
Did you intend to get that?
What did you, what were you thinking when you moved your lips?
What is the nature of your thoughts, gentlemen, when you say fuddle-duddle or something like that? God, you...
Yeah, fuddle-duddle. What the hell is fuddle-duddle anyway? That's not even a real word, folks. So it is when it comes to foul language revisionism. We have more from fuddle-duddle to Let's Go Brandon. Fascinating. Still, I wonder if those very same NASCAR fans had been chanting F Donald Trump, would the mainstream media sanitize that phrase for our collective protection? No, I think those journalistic jabronis would surely move into the public has the right to know mode on that particular nugget. But I was thinking the other day, now that Let's Go Brandon has entered the popular culture lexicon, how does one monetize it? Well, actually, some people already have. Earlier this month, the Billboard Hot 100 featured not one, but two songs titled Let's Go Brandon in its top 40 chart. Ka-ching! But you know who else could monetize this phrase, folks? A certain city in Manitoba. Yes, I speak of Brandon, Manitoba. Indeed, the stars are starting to align for this prairie town in terms of making use of this phrase. Just string together a litany of Let's Go Brandon recitals plucked from the internet. True, Brandon already has a tourism phrase, namely,
Brandon brings you back.
I don't know. The alliteration is there, but the message, it kind of hints at zombieism to me. But think of the energy Brandon could harness with our rapid-fire litany of diverse individuals chanting and even singing Let's Go Brandon as images of that city's tourist attractions, whatever those may be, fill the screen.
Let's go, Brandon. Hey. Let's go, Brandon. Hey. Let's go, let's go. Hey.
Oh, two thumbs up. And so it was that I reached out to Brandon's mayor, Rick Trest. I said to his honor, what about tapping into this global phenomenon? So in a way to promote his city. Well, here's the mayor's response. Quote, thanks for your note. I did have a Winnipeg radio station have some fun with that as well. That said, that while we have a sense of humor here in Brandon and we are always happy to receive any additional attention we can get for our community, we've decided we won't get too involved in this particular Let's Go Brandon phenomenon. Knowing the backstory, we know it may put us in the middle of partisan American politics. And of course, the phrase is a less savory code comment for the U.S. president. We don't feel it appropriate to get our community in the middle of partisan U.S. politics. So we'll just take a pass on engaging in this one. While the slogan sounds catchy, we do have our own slogan. We support Brandon Brings You Back, end quote. You know, folks, Mayor Tress strikes me as a really nice guy, befitting of someone who lives in friendly Manitoba. And granted, he makes some fair points, but judging by recent polls, an overwhelming majority of Americans would indeed justifiably use less than savory language to describe President Biden. And you know what? If Let's Go Brandon attracted a legion of conservatives and Republicans and pro-Trump supporters to Brandon, Manitoba, hey, I'm packing my bags and heading west, minus 40 wind chill factors and mosquitoes be damned. So please, Mayor, reconsider. After all, it's one thing to look a gift horse in the mouth. It's quite another thing to kick its teeth in. And for all you pinko, lying, liar, phony, baloney Marxists out there who have a problem with Let's Go Brandon, well, why don't you all go fuddle-duddle yourselves? For Rebel News, I'm David the Menzoid Menzies. Mandatory vaccine passports. Get the jabs or lose your jobs, and not even get employment insurance. We think that's wrong. We're fighting back in the court and amassing signatures on a petition. Please go to fightvaccinepassports.com. That's fightvaccinepassports.com. Sign the petition, and if you're in a position where you can give a contribution, please do so.